You mentioned photography, and as I guess everyone would be aware, photographic media and painting now are bound at the hip. Many prominent portrait painters employ photography to as an aid memoir, as a compositional aid, as a process of developing a composition. Is that how you approach?
Yeah, definitely. I find photography, it's kind of like my process of making a sketch, just the first stage. I can just put together what I want to paint, and you know, it's kind of like a sketch.
Because the picture is also correspondingly painterly. I mean, the technique is lovely and fluid, and sort of in a way anti-photographic. There's one thing that struck me very vividly. Just move this way. You've left the margin for a sketch down there, and also places up on the lower left and on the left margin. Why is that?
It's influenced by, because I paint from photographs, and photographs are cropped, so it's kind of leaving, like, not giving, like, not hiding anything, to the fact that I'm just painting, I've been influenced by painting from photographs, and also the process of painting, I couldn't afford the stretcher frame at the time, so I don't have to reflect that or not. Like that really, so when I stretch it after and paint it, it quite fit, but I felt like it.
Did you paint it on the floor?
No, I painted it on my wall.
Okay. But it wasn't stretched. Right. Ladies and gentlemen, are there any questions? Okay. Now you have artist and sitting duck. Now is the time to ask any questions that you might like to. Yes. So the question is, the lady asked that the painting doesn't smell like a painting. Might if it had an oil medium. So what the question is, what medium do you use?
I use oil paint, but I use a 1-2 Newton spreader medium. So
which is presumably without scent. You're not a dolloper. You like a thin paint film.
Yeah, for this case, yeah.
At Elam, I've been experimenting quite a bit with different art mediums and styles. So last year I actually decided to concentrate on painting. Not painting styles like this one, but just seeing what I could do with paint. Yeah, so it's a bit different to here, but I'm just taking the ideas that I've learned at Elam and bringing it into my own portraits, so you can see the development over the last 3 entries I've had, which is, yeah, influenced by Elam as well.
Yeah.
The question is, have you done life drawing?
I've done a few life drawing classes and one-on-one, but mainly been influenced by photography and capturing people in the moment. It kind of first began at high school. I did a series on the homeless people of Auckland, and it was kind of a process where I went and met these homeless people and captured them in the right moment, which of time, and yeah, kind of took it from there.
Any other questions? Yes. How long did it take Logan to complete the portrait?
It took 100 plus hours. It was about over a month and a half, and it was right down to the wire as well.
why painting rather than going with the medium of photography?
I just really passionate about painting. And I just love being on a canvas and using paint and the possibilities of paint. But yeah.
The question is, does Logan think he will end up concentrating on portraiture over other genres?
Yeah, I hope so. Over my few years at Elam, it's made me realise that this is what I really like doing over other mediums. And this year, for my honours degree at Elam, I'm going to focus on creating and developing a body of work influenced by this piece, so yeah, I hope to continue again.
Ladies and gentlemen, join me in thanking.